Hey guys, welcome to Filmora Pro. My name's Johnny, and today I wanted to show you how you can pull off this really cool walk-by transition effect. This effect can be a great way to smooth out a cut between two different shots with style in both narrative works and travel vlogs. So, let's take a look at an example of a walk-by transition. So what did JJ see on our camera? We may never know, but what I can show you is how we put this together. What we've got here is a medium shot of JJ looking at her camera. Then we have a couple people walking by, and as the second person walks by, it reveals a closer shot of JJ looking at the camera once again. You could use this transition to switch to a completely different shot, which works really well in travel vlogs. But I find in a narrative context like this one, it makes more sense to switch between two different sizes of the same shot. So let's go into Filmora Pro and step by step take you into how we did this. So the way we got this footage is we had our initial medium shot where JJ was looking at the camera and then had someone walk across the frame. We'll drag this into our timeline and put it on the second track. Next, we got a close-up shot on JJ with people walking across the frame again, followed by JJ's reaction. Let's put this on the first track, but later on the timeline. We'll line it up with our first shot later. You technically don't need to have someone walking across for the second shot, but I like having it there because it helps with timing on set. So what we want to do here is mask out the area behind our person walking left to right, so that we reveal this closer shot in the area behind him as he walks. I typically start by finding a frame of my top clip where the passing person is fully in frame. Next, I'll go to our rectangular mask tool and hold click on it until this drop-down menu appears. Let's select the freehand mask tool and begin drawing our mask along the back of our walker. We'll go a good bit outside of the frame for the rest of the mask, since we'll be feathering this mask and we don't want to accidentally feather other parts of the frame. Once we've finished our mask, let's go up to the controls panel and click the display timeline icon up here. Under shape, let's set our feather strength to about 50, and I'm going to set the roundness to about 10 to make our mask look a little more natural. Next, under transform, click this circle beside path to enable keyframing. We'll adjust the path of our mask as our person walks across the frame. A time-saving technique I would use for this is to first make an adjustment for every two frames, since our person's movement is pretty straightforward. So let's begin by zooming in and moving the playhead two frames forward. Next, highlight all the mask points on the back of the walker, and then move them so that they line up with their back again. We may need to adjust individual points to get it just right. The main goal is to make sure that we can't see any background objects behind the walker's back. Repeat this process every two frames forward until our character is off frame. This is where we'll end the clip in the timeline. Let's return to our first keyframe and work backwards just like before. He's actually filling the left edge of this frame, so we'll move the mask all the way over. And then let's go one frame in between and make our adjustment. There we go. Now let's scrub over our frames and see if there are any outliers where things still don't look right, and we'll make the adjustments accordingly. If you're still seeing a little bit of background detail, another thing you can do is take the expansion value and bring it down a teeny bit. When you're done, your clip should look like this. Side note, you can get this checkerboard background that I have here by going to Options, Checkerboard Background. I just like using it because it helps me tell what's transparent. Next, let's take our shot on the first video track and line it up until the action looks just right. Not here. And right about there. If you're not getting smooth playback, you can try setting a lower quality setting, like a quarter, and setting your playback quality to draft. And there we go, we've just created a walk-by transition. Are there any other cool transitions you'd like to learn how to make in Filmora Pro? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for more Filmora Pro tutorials every other Thursday. I'll see you guys in the next video. And remember, there's no limit to what you can create.